Hello guys, welcome back to our new series. Wolf is preferred the cool floor instead of his bed. We have some normal temperatures for the time. We're about 22-24 degrees, but Wolf is feeling hot because I haven't turned on the air condition yet. Don't need to. Wolf? Say hi, Wolf. Say hi. Wolf! 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 Okay, got it. His ball is under the bench. How stupid of me. Wolf! Okay, that's why he preferred the cold floor. He wanted his ball. Wolf! If only you could talk. Wolf! Wow! So guys, let's leave Wolf. He will manage the entire project and come to what we're about to do. What we're going to do is build the HMS Endeavour. Endeavour, I believe it's Endeavour. What's different in this project is that I have no instructions in paper. I have them in a CD. So, let me check out the instructions for the first step and I'll get back to you to begin. So guys, let me show you a couple of things. I haven't figured out now at the time what the pieces I need are, but I want to show you that there's something I like in this model that Artesania has. I've seen it once more in the San Juan Nepomuceno, and I will tell you what they did as a mistake in the San Juan Nepomuceno. Hopefully, from what I'm seeing here, this mistake does not exist at the moment. We will find out much later. What they do, and I like, is that they tell you the pieces with the appropriate number and letter, so you don't have to spend time to find out which is which and try to write it on. Only probably in pieces like this one. What they did in Nepomuceno that it was a mistake is that they have used the numbering in parts that you were able to see, like the keel. And it's a little bit impossible to hide it because it's burnt wood. So even with wood putty, it would be visible. The only way to hide it is to use wood putty and then paint it. I believe that this is not the current situation, so hopefully everything is done properly. So let me check out what the pieces we need are, and I'll get back to you to start cutting. So the first thing we're going to make is the main part of the skeleton, the keel. We need the pieces Q1, Q2, Q3. Let me find them. Q3 is right here. Q2 is right here. Q1. Let's separate them. Q1 is at the bottom of the keel, so it will be visible, but in this model the keel is painted white, so it won't. Okay. Q1, Q3 must be two pieces, so this is the other one. And Q2. Now we're going to connect these pieces. Of course, we'll have to wait for the glue to dry, but I will continue with the rest. You will see what I mean. First of all, let's sand down the cuts. Doesn't need much. That's what I was trying to avoid, but okay, easy to fix. Thank you. Now, I will leave this to dry and I'll get back to you. Now guys, I have to separate all the pieces from C1 up to C11. This will take some time. Let me do that and I'll get back to you. I'll want to do exactly the same as before, separate them, trim them, make them even, and then I'll get back to you because this is a different procedure from all the others that I have made. Here you see all the pieces for the main skeleton. The C1 and C11 are going to be used later on. We have the main piece drying. In each and every model I've made before, these pieces were one. Here, for each piece, we have three. C2, C3, C4, C5, C6, C7, C8, C9, and C10. Don't know why Artesania did that. That's will take a lot of time to be done. This is left, this is right. We have a perfect fit, but cyanoacrylic glue won't do any good here. Because, as you can see, it plays, it moves. So we have to use the type of glue, the white type of glue. And I have to do it in two steps. First one side, then the other, because I have to lay it down to a surface like the bench to let it dry. Or else I'm going to have problems. I have to make sure that these are straight, because see here, if I move it a little bit, this opens up. If I move it over here, closes up. So if this is not aligned correctly, we're going to have a big problem when we lay on the deck. Honestly, don't know why they did that. This is one of the most crucial parts of the building of the ship. This must be aligned to the millimeter. And here, we're going to have problems. I'm pretty sure about that. Fixable, but problems. So, what I'm going to do? Glue one side on each and every one. Let it dry, flip it around, glue the other side, and see how it will work. The pieces are drying. Once this side is complete, it's dry, I will flip them over, do exactly the same on the other side, and then I'll get back to you to continue with the skeleton. And here we are again. For you it was just a moment, for me it was an entire day. I have glued everything, both sides, the glue is dry. Don't worry about the gaps you see, they're filled with glue. This type of glue is white when you use it, and when it's dry it becomes transparent. Now, up to the next step. What we're going to do now is to mark every piece so we know where the center is, because we have to make sure that each of these pieces are placed vertically and do not lean to the left, to the right, to the front or the back. So with this way that I'm going to show you, it's going to be very easy to understand if the piece is not centered. All you have to do is draw two lines according to the cut you have here. both sides, that is, to make it makes easier to mount them. Doesn't make any difference if the lines are not completely centered. What makes a difference in the lines must be straight. So this is one. I have to do all the pieces, so let me do that and I'll get back to you. So guys, also had to cut, separate these pieces. These are the bases for the masts. If I remember correctly, yeah, the base for the mast, for the mast. So leave them to the side for a moment and let's begin. I have it this the other way around. I need number one piece, and let me number them as well. So we eliminate the possibility of mistake. This is set one. Here the things are easier. You can see here that the set one goes here. This is set two, set three, set four, set five. C6, L2, L1, these are for the masts. C7, 8, L3, 9, 10, 11. So this one goes over here. I will place them. Let me see. This is the front of the ship, definitely. This is the rear. So this is the bow, this is the stern. According to the plans, let me check. I'm looking at the photo right now. The piece goes with the letters in front. So if the letters are in front, this is the right, this is the left. Okay, don't know why, maybe there's some reason for that. So this one is playing around freely. That means we have a perfect fit, but not that good. So this, I will leave this for last, or maybe I could use some cyanoacrylic glue. It's playing, you can see it. Cyanoacrylic glue to hold it in position until the white glue does its work. Completely vertical. Let's see now, what do I have to make? Oh yeah, the ruler, to make sure that it's vertical. Give me a moment. Done it. Completely vertical. So now what glue? Nothing on the front. Let's continue. C2. Like I said, this is the left side. Sorry, this is the right side. This is the left side over here towards me. So this goes over here. Also this one, not a perfect fit. This is wrong. It's not a perfect fit. The pieces should be inside and should stay there, not be able to move around. Again, the same trick. This is where the L1 goes. This is the L1. I will do all the pieces exactly the same way, and I'll get back to you to show you the finished result, because this will take some time. And done. Everything needs to dry. So I will leave it here. I'm not going to touch it. And one thing that I don't like for the time being is the thickness of the pieces. There's just 3 millimeters. I've never done a model with the skeleton so thin. There should be at least 5 or even 4, it's better, but the skeleton should be at least 5 millimeters. Anyway, and 4 will do the job, but 3 is very thin. So the entire structure is fragile. And I don't know if this structure has any reinforcements. Probably the decks, what you see here, are going to be the reinforcement. And that could be a problem. This could be a problem with twisting hull. We will see. As far the skeleton is not easy and it's very fragile. So this is phase one. I'll get back to you to the phase two. We have some more pieces to throw on. This is not done yet. Thank you very much for watching, guys. Wolf is having his nap. Take a look at that. Don't film me while I'm sleeping. Okay. Thank you very much for watching, guys. See you soon.